Oh boy. I cannot believe. What is it? It's like 3:05. I went to bed early. Man, it was like too early, but you know, I was just trying to escape by going to sleep. Where am I even is? Let's see. Gotta get my implants going and things. And I'm trying to look around and see. I got some new music, which I'm ready for it. So, but I'm not sure. I've been downloading stuff and on my, let me give me a shout out to my digital juice of things. That's, yeah, I got that. Alright, so let's see what happens. Let's start this up. Maybe this will get me in the mood. I'm hoping I get some skills. I don't know, man. I'm new to this. Oh. Oh, I got Rosa. I do have Rosa. So I can actually do this prize fight thing today. Let's see. Oh, I gotta raise up her rank. I don't think I'm gonna have that kind of coin. Not gonna have it. Job, turkey. Looking around, I'm wondering how good can it get. You know, it's like I don't see myself spending money in here. That's like a one-armed bandit kind of thing. Okay, so I think Alma 1923 is a real person. Making me mad now. For a buck. You are an annoyance. Thank you.
Shaka Khan. Is that the real Shaka Khan, or is that a bot?
The champion, and thanks God that he had not forsaken them in their tradition. He would find fault with them for laboring in the propagation of Rukun's conflict. But by preaching against it in their focus, and by prohibiting its sale as far as they could, the good princes of the stamp of the Pomona Dominicans did most of the serving of it.
Thank you.
surges of the imprisoned real court, and everything here to a degree was most employed. Utterly dumbfounded, that your Americans listen to the very being of the which entirely frustrated their schemes and machinations. Considering the known boldly dare discuss his anger at the denial of their rights. The other Confederates slumped away ashamed, followed by the cheers of the street boys, and the cry of men, or the peace brothers, who wished to outrage a just man, on the ones at the stake. It is true, as the Americans relate, that the rabbis of Germany met in the Synod in Worms, and found the defeat of the Roman Confederation as moving aside of the downfall of the Roman 453 Papist hierarchy, they were certainly endowed with prophetic vision. It was also said that Reuchlin had secret intercourse with rabbis. Reuchlin was by no means so situated as to be able to triumph over his enemies and those of the Jews. Though subdued for the moment, they were certainly not vanquished. He knew their cunning and malignity too well to give himself up to an act of enjoyment of his victory. He knew that their persecutions would only be redoubled in the future. Therefore, he hastened to announce his appeal to the Pope, so that silence might be imposed on that order of his bitter enemies. But Reuchlin justly feared them.
Oh, a Swedish taboo.
The Jewish position of the Pope's begging him to plead for the Pope's favor in his cause. Leo, who was already down at the Medici, got from his father and said that he would appoint his own sons, as it seemed to the papal child 3 months before. He was
an man on Discord.
A Roman pagan rather than a Catholic priest, looking down with contempt on the heights on theological controversy as Charles May. The only considered Pope best is here between two orange states, Oklahoma and Casper, and Valois, without the angry resemblance to the Roman Catholic hierarchy. Anybody who surprised us today, the Pope ventured to say, we do not know how useful the scale of Christ has been to us and ours. Calling him a stupid villain. The nuns of the your own rudeness and hand over your wrists. Use mutual hatred brought them at times to blows. The motto one was, bless you of Yarjin's anger and preservation of the tonic, and of the other, damnation and destruction to both. Voluntarily the rudeness became friends of the Jews, and sought grounds on which to defend them. The appearance of the rudeness became fiercer enemies to the Jews, and sought out of school books to prove their rudeness. The order of Diego the word of this contest spread to the Jews. At first, in the defense, the contest soon reached both Rome and Paris. It is written that the Dominicans worked with energy to overshadow the scale of growth, in the latter place by the greatest university, the former by the papal see, and to have the rudeness writing sentenced to the flames. In both places, they had powerful and influential allies, who devoted and zealously worked for their party. Although his suit had been lawfully won in the apostolic court, Caesar was forced to take steps to counteract the appeal instituted by the intrigues of his enemies. And his friends received an influence in the Pope. Leo escorted the cardinal and patriarch Domenico to Milan as Jacob the Farmer. It was well known that this king was the best country in the legal order, and his patriarch was the smaller, leading the Dominicans, and the Greek Messiah. Without that prominent Jew overlooking Roman politics, but, like the German Jews, they had a good sense to keep in the background, so as not to imperil the cause by standing in as Jewish. Cardinal Bernardi issued Jew, in 1814, a summons to both parties, but in consideration of Greek men's advanced years, he had to send a representative, while Hustrain had to appear in person. Furnished with recommendations and well filled purse, the inquisitor appeared in Rome with undiminished confidence of obtaining a victory. But could not be obtained before the army. He did not have anything to offer. He was poor. He had not the magic wand which commands the invaders, all the plunderers, and several public guests, who were our treasure dealers. But there was no lack of information to express the throne issues. Emperor Maximilian, much to his own regret, destroying the already rotting body of the Catholic Church. The Jews and the Tonic were the first cause of the Lutheran quarrel. Naturally, they could not be forced to teach him that canon account in the letters of the Esperantists. So it happens that Lamush decides Jews became one of the topics of the day. A girl of laughter is now between Western Europe and the Indies terrible letters. Everyone in Germany, England, France, and English who want to speak Latin, were stuck with the foreign and terrible confessions of divinities and scholastics. Their author Bavardi, Dense Supe, egregious volume, and period word and deep, seems so glaringly in contrast with their presumed learning and propriety, that the most serious men were moved to murder. It is related that Erasmus, who, at the time of reading the letters, suffered from the last so widely known and to his cure. Their comedy of fools was written entirely correct, and the Dominicans were judged by publicity, no matter how the Pope might deal with them. All the curious know that he offered. Some thought it was simply himself, others Erasmus, Hector, or one of the humanist court, but he gave the right answer to the question as to the author, God himself. It appears more and more clearly that this led to cause that the burning of the town had taken a worldwide significance, so what he did was serving only to further the interests of all. In Roman code, was he knew the interests of the biblical prophets. Only the German Jews were not indulged in their end. The Dominicans had many time worked in another way to attain their object, where it somehow depend on the Jews.
Another point. The catalyst formed the background of this movement. Out of luck for this secret offer, suppose
is the author of the Key to Jesus Knowledge of Philosophy and Christianity, Lutheran had wished to spare the Talmud, because in his opinion it contained mystery elements. The Beautiful Catalog became the patronus of the Old Talmud. Lutheran understood the literal Catalogistic doctrines, but his eagerness for knowledge and his zeal spurred him on to study. Moreover, the attack on his adversary upon his orthodoxy, honesty, and erudition, had needed an air of honor for him to prove convincingly that he had no agree with Christianity. But he was unfortunate to be chosen his key models. For a long time, she saw a life, until chance brought him to the most complete source of information, the English writings of the Catalyst, Joseph John Isserlein, of Castile, which the convert Paul Riccio had lately translated into Latin. As soon as Lutheran heard of the literary treasure of Joseph John Isserlein, he did not rest till he had attained it, and again set about proving that the Catalyst was in agreement with Christianity. Believing that the Catalyst reveals and confirms the highest truths, mysteries of Christianity, Lutheran composed a work on Catalyst science, and dedicated it to Pope Leo X, leading Unicus to 467 his contention that the Jewish writings, instead of being burnt, should be cherished. Lutheran must have counted on the approval of the Pope, to whom he dedicated the work, who having found new support from modern faith. Even that Leo X would at length grant him peace and rest by pronouncing judgment to be sued between himself and the Dominicans, which, though suppressed, was persistently urged by the latter. The Christian-like Catalo was to be his intercessor and guide. He did not stand alone in his foolish fondness for the secret doctrine. Not only the cardinals but the Pope himself affected to gain much for Christianity by proper research into the Catalo. As the interest in the Lutheran controversy began to flag, another movement started in Germany, continuing, as the other had begun, to shake the firm pillars of the papacy and the Catholic Church, and prepare the regeneration of Europe. The discussion aroused by the Talmud created an intellectual meeting favorable to determination and growth of Luther's reform movement. Destined soon to become a force in the world's history, even the Reformation arose from small beings, and needed both powerful protection not being given up. Martin Luther was a strong, straightforward, obstinate and passionately excited in character, willing with tenacity to his convictions and errors. By the opposition which he met, Luther finally came to the conclusion that each individual pope, consequently the papacy, was not infallible, and that the basis of faith was not the pope's will, but the scriptural word. The death of the old emperor, Maximilian, who had been unequal to the task of grappling with the truth, spun out for half a year, threw politics into the arena, and gave rise to 468 to confusion in which the friends and foes of three religious content of Louis Lothar's favor were not distinguishable, Hutton and the humanist's favor Charles B., in his own country, Spain, where the humanist still had the upper hand, and where the claims of his state were still unextinguished. But he was opposed by the Pope. The Lutherans and the Lutheran Protestants, as it were, Talmud and the Reformation, emerged into each other. So great a change had taken place that the electors assembled to elect an emperor declared against the Esperantists set alone in favor of Luther. Instead of condemning the Talmud, Pope Leo X encouraged the printing of the work. Thus, through a movement incomprehensible to all his contemporaries, the unacceptance of this, Luther was justified, and the Talmud was justified, and in a measure favored by the Pope. Indeed, Daniel Bonner, a rich Christian publisher and emperor, in the same year brought up the creation of the Catholic Church of the Volumes, the model of all the editions. The letter Hattai, which first appeared in Latin French, and has been translated into German, portrays Luther as the originator of the great and growing movement. He represents a doctor, on whose arm he is going to be the same throwing a bundle of straight and religious sticks on the stage, as a word. Another Peter in Brussels, having the name endeavored to put London in order, shakes his head over the chaos, and disappears. And he also runs away. And the bottom end is the perfect straits. He strikes with his sword, spreading fire, only giving a wider flame. At length comes the Pope, who, wishing to extinguish the fire, seizes a vessel, and pours the oil in it upon the flames, then clasps his hands on 469 his head, while the bright flames shoot up never again to be seen.
Jesus
was born a Jew. Luther expressed himself in asking God the nature of Jesus still more sharply. In those years, the Catholics, vicious, sucks to send us. Have you so dealt with these, that every good Christian would rather than a Jew? And if I am a Jew, and seen such stupid and such luck as being Christian church, I would rather than anything than a Christian. They are treated me as they lost, by them. They have nothing but my life. They are not relations of our own.
Ouch.
Your property boasts of flesh and blood.
Help!
Therefore, my dear prophets, if you become tired of using me as a parody, have you used to revile me as a Jew? Therefore, it is my advice. Continue your work, allow me treat them kindly. Now that we drive them by force, treating them deceitfully and ignominiously, saying that they must be Christian blood and wash away the Jewish skin, and I will not live more nonsense, preventing them from working amongst us, from living and having social intercourse with us, forcing them to be Jews, forcing them to make them come to us.
I'm gonna deal with my mouse lock. Yeah. With my mouse locking up like that, man, I'm in bad shape. I'm gonna leave the team.
The Holy Hosts were entertained of the speedy downfall of Rome, and the approaching redemption by the Messiah. But the Jews were to gain much more by the Reformation of the Jewish race. Besides before, it became fashionable, so to say, in the early days of the Reformation. Lutheran and expressed a modest wish that the huge German university's professor of the Hebrew language might be a boy. Through the zeal for Hebrew being published, shortly before his death, the work on the absence and paucity, and through the increasing condition of the Baptist knowledge, the Bible must remain a sealed book. Princes and universities saw teachers, and instituted Hebrew professors not only in Germany and Jews, but also in France and Rome. Classic use, which had withdrawn many parts from the church, was more and more neglected, and the serious Hebrew mother was sought out to set. Not an old did not hesitate to seek Jews from whom to learn Hebrew. A friendly connection was born between Jewish masters and Christian peoples, to the intense vexation of the
I'm looking at
sides.
My,
And many prejudices died out by these means. The principal teacher of the Christians was a grammarian of German descent, Elias Levita, born 1468, died 1549. This poor man, who had to struggle for his daily bread, laid the foundation of the knowledge of four sadly to the Hebrew language. The plundering of Padua here, perhaps, he was born in, by way of Venice, to Rome, where Cardinal Isidore de Viterbo, wishing to advance his grammatical and cabalistic studies, took him to his house, supporting him and his family for more than 10 years. Not only this church dignitary, but many other Christians in high positions sat at Levita's feet. One was George Desai.
I'm trying to look at my system performances.
As he was against the reproach of some bigoted rabbis, Levita defended himself by the remark that his Christian people all were friends of the Jews, and tried to promote their welfare. On the inducement of his patron, Egeo, he worked out a Hebrew grammar in the Hebrew language, the greater part of which was translated into Latin by Lutheran's people, Sebastian Menster. Elias Levita had brought a mind on great depth, nor did he propound a new theory on the structure of the Hebrew language. Clearly, was written in the grammatical system of the Kinshies, because he did not know their predecessors. His usefulness consisted in his command over the whole scriptural vocabulary, his pedagogic skill, and his intuitive presentation. Beyond the elements he did not know, but they perfectly satisfied the wants of the tongue. Only one deviation did Levita make from the Kinshies. Against the firm belief of the time and the absence of the vowel signs in the Hebrew Bible were of ancient origin.
What is com surrogate?
Or, at all events, introduced by Ezra, he maintained that they had not been known even at the time of the Talmud, because they had been superfluous when Hebrew was a living language. It can easily be imagined what the storm of his opinion raised. It had once upset all preconceived notions. But we get to raise
I'm
the
going back
in. He had by his instructions his own Judaism. Elias
I'm trying to have this on fire.
He learned Chinese rather for 73 Jews, and associate more with learned Christians, which brought much learning from the older guys, and produced evil consequences for his descendants. He was not the only teacher of the Hebrew language and literature to Christians. As before him, both guys learned had been moved in instruction in Hebrew, so at the same time as Trumpa, Jacob Montino and Abraham of Almas were engaged in instructing Christians. Throughout Christendom there was a desire to know the Hebrew language. The French were driving on such good sales that in several places in Indian Germany, even where there were no Jews, new and old Hebrew grammatical writings were published. Everyone wished to know Hebrew and to understand the Hebrew language and literature. Some years ago, the representatives of the church had considered the knowledge of Hebrew superfluous, but even the pernicious Hebrew spectrum on earth. The information became unnecessary for the community. Luther himself learned Hebrew to be able to penetrate the meaning of the Bible, which he defined was most evident in mass. The person of the church was the leader of thought, and by a majority of the nation, he was the leader of the Talmud and Hebrew studies. Scarcely 6 years later, there was a professorship at the printing press of Hebrew, and a confessor of cleanliness, William Herman Pate, who had given the only standard that brought about the confirmation of Luther's work, appeared as a major person. Invited the Bishop of Corsica, Augustine de Signani, a man well read in Hebrew literature, to come to France. This young king felt, or at least showed, interest in Rome and also in the study of Hebrew. He invited Elias Levita to come to France, and filled the professorship of Hebrew there, probably at the instigation of poor Samuel Fields' admirer, himself. One must take into consideration what was signified at that time. In France proper, for more than a century, no Jew had been permitted to dwell, or even to make a passing stay, and now a Jew was invited, not merely to find air, but to accept an honorable place and instruct Bishop. What heresy! Elias Levita, however, declined this flattering proposal. He would not fulfill the needs there as no Jew, so the to France was not in conformity with his character. Just in the army undertook the task of introducing the study of Hebrew into France. At the University of London, the French students made attempts to speak Hebrew. As there were not sufficient grammars, just in the army had a wretched Hebrew grammar of Moses Kinshi accepted. Therefore, the Bible was in fact in Paris, where 300 years previously the Jewish one Fox Bonnie, who had learned Hebrew Hebrews, had learned to make these Hebrew philosophical work, by other perplexed, the minimum to see how he now calls around the translation of Saint to be published 1520. Naturally, the Christian teachers of the Hebrew language remained dependent on their Jewish masters. They could not take a single step without them. Paulus Logius, a reforming priest and disciple of Berkman, wishing to establish a Hebrew presidency, called upon Elias Lydia to go there. Was in difficulties, and could find no publisher for his Chaldean and Hebrew dictionaries. Paulus Logius was particularly deep with these words, because they appeared to be the Hebrew grammar, so much sought for by Christian scholars. Through the agitation by Lutheran and Hebrew, the signs of the Bible was to a certain extent cultivated. They were quite strange to the followers of both the 1975 the glorious memorial and much greater time of Christian and Zionism and the centers of the nations. So it seemed by the accessories that its full value was completely unknown. Because everything was looked for in, and included into, the Holy Scriptures, the true meaning was not discovered. To the Christian man, the Bible had been inaccessible for a long time, because of papacy, the instinctive fear, had forbidden its translation into the vernacular. So the faithful knew only fragments of isolated texts, and, owing to distorted interpretations, these not always correct. Even the clergy were not familiar with, for they were only in the Roman Catholic Latin version, and in this country the church said the Bible were confused by perversions and errors. It was, therefore, a work of great importance that occupied Luther and his solitude on the word for he translation of the Bible, the Old and New Testaments, into German. When he heard his Luther has learned Luther, and seeking the mission of Jesus. To his contemporaries it seemed as if God's word for the first time in the field. This weird voice they had never before heard. The breath of fresh air was wafted on them, when the ramparts were broken down that had so long held its nerve imprisoned. God's great magic became the introduced of a small people. He practically rejuvenated the whole generation, once more infusing one of simplicity and naturalness. The Bible was soon translated into all European languages. The Catholics themselves were obliged to restore the papal command, and render it into intelligible language for the people's use. The Jews also felt the want of a Holy Scripture in the natural. The translation of the Spanish language was large, by the way, 14th, who had escaped by Paul, and called himself Abraham the son of a Jew. The demand for Hebrew Bibles was so great that Yosemite's annual longer undertook the great work of publishing the Old Testament, with the commentaries of Rashi, Ibn Ezra, Hinch, Verslies, and others. The sale of this remarkable Bible was so rapid that munitions were continually appearing. 477. Chapter SV. The Cataract of the Fanaticism. The Miranda's of the Inquisition. Internal confusion of Jewish religion for the communities who have been interested in military historical studies to keep those dialogues above up courtesy of the Cataract of the Cataract of the Miranda's of the Inquisition. The immunity traveler David Bowie then hit the Roman Mulcho's relations to David Bowie then years of Pearl and his back then VIII showed on Conan Rome's video and the Conan's name football showed the enthusiastic regard in which he was hard worked to cause all I Carol's feet and which is handled on Costa. 1500-1538 CE. It is Sanja, yet not Sanja, that is certain movement, and also being that sure that this reward of political in the first quarter of 1613 whilst among Christians a radical change took place, in modern Christians, and even in the whilst the raging presence of usages were rejected for Greek society in some places, and in others freshened up. In a word, whilst everyone started, everything was unchanged by the Jews. Having had no believers, they needed no new weapons. They needed no regeneration, they had no moral force of life to reach us, no tangering motion to cure, no time to raise a hand. Received from olden times, and became filled with unintelligible elements, so that, on the whole, it acquired an unattractive character. Sermons were unknown in German congregations and their options. Thus, some new religious sources were highly unintelligible to the people, especially to women, and, therefore, leading them cold and uninterested, or dimmer. The Spanish and Portuguese preachers spoke in the beautiful language of their country, but their sermons were so full of pedantry that they were no more easily understood by the lady. The breaking of their Jewish congregations to national groups was also a solution. Persecution of the Jews had thrown into large towns already entered the fugitives from the Mariana of Germany. Built in Arkansas with the existing congregations, yet did not accommodate each other. There were, therefore, in many towns, not only Italian, Romanic, Spanish, Portuguese, German, and, now and again, Moorish African congregations, but many of them were provinces and towns in Europe. For example, in Constantinople, Adrianople, Salonika, Ardabar in Greece, and many other towns, there was a large variety of congregations, each of which had its own directors, ritual, rabbi, academy, charities, its own pledges and elements. In the face of such division, nothing for the public benefit or general good could be accomplished. The spiritual beings, although generally moral, and, as a rule, sincerely and firmly religious, humbled themselves before the rich members of their congregation, witnessing insolence and missing up without daring to approve of. Worse than this, splitting up into tiny congregations 479 was the famous, the narrow-mindedness, the self-abasement, not merely of German Jews, but of the Sephardic exiles. Only when it was necessary to die for the faith of their fathers did they show themselves heroic and full of courage. At other times their activity was extended on petty concerns. No new course was taken, not even at sight of the daily changes of the Christian world. On the plains of science, the German traffic, served as a remnant of war. The main idea was to elucidate all gods and old acres, and to write commentaries, even super commentaries. Talmudists explained the tonic, and the philosophical inquirers remained unified. Higher flight of fancy and greater spiritual insight were not wanting. No sound of real poetry came from the lips of those nourished on it, not even a grand song of revelation, came from breathing into words. One circumstance testified to the position of time messages in historical research, and that was almost entirely confined to the Jews of Roman descent. The endless suffering they had endured, they wished to preserve for future generations. Present as we walk forward in the sorrows of our ages, and show that the history of the Jewish people is a lot of us in the end of the year. imagination than reality, and his reflections are suggestive rather than true. Possibly beyond the ego put his deeper thoughts into a work, now lost, entitled The Harmony of Heaven. His dialogues of love throughout was far removed from Judaism. Beyond the ego paid high honor to Hebrew Zurich, and endeavored to uphold the spiritual doctrine of creation out of chaos, in opposition to the principles of Greek philosophy, but he did not penetrate to the true spirit of Judaism. Therefore his work was more and valued by Christians more than by Jews. The Italians were proud to see he was the first time philosophical thought made down in their own enthusiasm in another language. The work became a full degree of the educated class, and in the space of 20 years went through apologies. The catalog of his teacher race seemed to possession of minds no longer accustomed to school level discipline, and in a measure filled it with. In the 16th century he first began to cosplay on men's minds. His adversaries were dead, one mysterious place of justification to the edge of the page, and he was strongly inclined to mysteries, where an officer of the
Barbie, come on! Barbie, did you just send a message, Chef? The chef. And give this man some money. Because he needs the dough. What's up, man? I just saw the message. I don't know if you're still there. Bongo. I guess all these are bots, huh? But they have different personalities, it seems. But it could be my own unconscious mind, like projecting personalities onto these weird names. I was thinking if they're all bots, that it's like sometimes that like real toe hours really tears me up. Pisses me off the Streamlabs is like that. I need a real distinctive chime, you know, when someone hits chat. I guess he's probably in battle. That's probably what it is.
Thank you.
Help! You're gonna kill me!
Gator brush.
Are we dying?
I'm trying to remember what Chef Lajos name is. Wait, let me get off this thing. This box anyway. And actually, I'm dogging as well. I need to go look at my CPU. But orders of this description were made only to be evaded. Spanish Morandos had every reason to envy their fellows in Portugal, and spared no trouble to escape beyond the frontier of the land where the steak was ready, and the faggots lighted for them. Very naturally, the vindictive Spanish government opposed them, and induced Manuel to pass a law that no Spaniard could step on Portuguese soil unless he brought a certificate that he was not guilty of heresy. The Portuguese Morandos, then, would have had a tolerable existence if popular hatred of them had not been so fierce. This unfriendliness after their baptism shows that they were hated less as followers of Judaism than as a different race, and an active, industrious, superior class. The Christians dislike of them increased when the converts attained the right of pursuing a trade, of collecting church tithes, of taking office, of even accepting ecclesiastical dignities preparatory to entering one of the orders. At first they showed their hatred by calling them insulting names, first convert of the Duke of Milano, Converso, till Manuel stopped his by law. Bad harvests, which for many years had brought famine into Portugal, now resulted in a plague, and this added fuel to popular animosity. It was commonly said, the baptized Jews are grain spectators. They make the necessary supplies here, and export grain to foreign countries. The person most hated was Manuel Sanchez, the farmer of Texas, and heard him all the Milano's incurred hatred. This hatred was employed by the pastor of Milton City, the exaltation of the favors of King Manuel. See, this is worse.
They not only preached about the godlessness of the converts, but in the numbers
of when I click the mouse, and it don't work.
The moment was
out
of tune. The plague of King Portugal, on present of the Milton City, while continued to threaten another bad harvest. Of these troubles, the Miranda was only caused, and he was already dead. The Dominicans now became maintained, in one of their churches, and their attacks were strong. The man had appeared in a glow of fire, and other astonishing miracles had been seen in it. They were practicing such deceits. Many people flocked to the church to behold him father. On the Sunday after Easter, April 1956, the church was filled with devotional believers, among them Miranda's, who were compelled to attend. At midnight, in a passionate sermon, charged the people collected in the church to murder the accursed converts, because the king favored them. And two others, Don Otto and Peter Gerardo, walked through the street, bearing crosses, as, crying heresy, heresy. The son of the populace in the turn of the capital was around, and, together with German, Dutch and French sailors, took this opportunity to plunder. Thus nearly 10,000 people went through the town, called by Miranda's, and, soon in German, wherever they found them, in the streets, in the houses, or in hiding. This, however, by no means ended the massacre. It continued 2 days longer. They were the only ones, too, possessed of a knowledge of medicine and physical science and all pertaining to it. There were in Portugal hardly any but Jewish, that is to say, Morano physicians. When, however, other influences were brought to bear on Joe, and he gradually freed himself from these wise counselors, his worried mind and the testation of the converts gained the upper hand. Queen Catherine, the Spanish Infanta, filled with admiration of the religious tribunal of the country, and the bloodthirsty Dominicans, and use of the power of their leader in Spain, besieged the king of the place of disgraceful and wicked conduct of Morano's and urged him to the Morano's rise to the Inquisition. Joe heard their confession, George immediately to inquire into the life of Miranda's community, their headquarters, and to voice him upon us. And it was often not proper the truth and informed the King July, 1524, that some Miranda's observed the Sabbath and the Passover, that, on the other hand, they joined in Christian rites and ceremonies as little as possible. Were not present at mass and divine service. Did not go to confession. Did not ask that the stream of be administered to time. Were very unconsecrated ground. Not in the churchyard. Now they have no houses set for their departing relatives. And moved under the rest of the senior hydro. The judge was not satisfied with the legal report. The Marianas will be under the same houses. The converts will be under the same. Name of great news. The UFO was received from the church and honored his own provide. Was chosen by a key to sign upon them. In the school of the blood nurse he was terrible. He had acquired the fierce nature of the Marianas. And it was his honest wish to see that that is too unfortunate.
Honor, and the scene of success with the next two comedy.
transported from Portugal to the Israelite army in Arabia and Nubia. David's plans in Portugal seems to have changed payment towards the Morales, and Joe has refused to give up the intended persecution of them. For so great an undertaking, Joe would need their support, their money, and their advice. If he wished to bring alliance with the Peter King people, he must pour 94 not persecute the half-jays of his own country. So the zeal of the establishment of the Inquisition in Portugal suddenly cooled. One can imagine the astonishment of Joe and the Morales in Portugal, and they understood that not only might Joe be admitted into Portugal, but that he was received at court, and treated with respect. Thus, then, had come the hour of deliverance of which they had so long dreamed. Unexpected help had come to them, freedom and deliverance from their anguish. They breathed again. Whether or not David ruined any of the Peter King people in Portugal did not matter to the Morales. They believed it, and counted the days to the time when he would make them behold the Inquisition of his soul. They pressed around him, kissed his hands, and treated him as if he were their king. From Portugal, the supposed message of salvation passed to the still more unfortunate Moranos there, who received it with ecstasy of joy. These poor people had fallen into a morbid, eccentric, irresponsible state of mind. Daily and hourly they suffered torment of soul, through having to join the religious Christians who supported their whole heart. It was known that many of them lost their mental balance, and became quite mad. In the vicinity of Morana named the angels of the prophets. Fell into transcendent visions. Declared that she could see Moses and the angels, and promised to lead her suffering from into the holy land. She found many believers among the Moranos, and when this was discovered, she was burned together with 38 adherents. Messianic expectation, that is, redemption through a miracle, in the atmosphere in which the Moranos breathed and lived. And the news of the arrival of the master from the Jewish community had appeared to discourse, a crowd of Spanish converts fled to Portugal to near their supposed 495 Regina. David, who enjoyed the privilege of traveling about in Portugal, appears to have behaved very circumspectly. He gave them no promises, and did not encourage them openly to acknowledge Jesus. He knew well that he was walking on the edge of a precipice, and that one expression, one act of his directing towards him uniting Christians to Jews, might cost him his life. Nevertheless, all eyes were fastened on him. All were aroused and excited by the wonderful events which would certainly come to pass. David ruined his appearance and the hopes of waving took strongest hold upon one noble, talented, handsome youth. Indeed, the whole course of his existence was changed. Now your good parents warned about 1501, died a martyr, 1532, whose willing, who had his imagination under more favorable circumstances might have accomplished much in the domain of the beautiful, became a tyrant and hands of self-proclaimed envoy for Shibar. Hires, who was born a new Christian, had acquired a good education. He understood and received Latin, the universal language of the time, he had risen to be royal secretary of the High Court of Justice, and was a great favorite at court. With Hebrew and Latin literature, he must have been familiar from his earliest youth, and he had been initiated into the Torah, probably by one of the Morano teachers. At the time when David and his hierarchical friends made so much stir in Portugal, that Jurgen Christ was, who they possessed by wild dreams and visions, all of which had a messianic background. He hastened, therefore, to David, to ascertain whether his mission was in accordance with these visionary revelations. David ruined many appears to have treated him with coldness, and to have told him plainly that his military embassy had nothing to do with messianic mysticism. Their time of empires fancied the coldness of the shock which he owned to circumstances for 96 that he had not accepted the sign of the COVID, and he failed to proceed to undergo the dangerous operation of
I'm getting a frame lag.
David was highly incensed when Pires told him of this, as both of them would be in danger, if it came to the king's ears that Morano had said and openly declared himself a Jew. Likely he asserted that David had persuaded him to take this course. After circumcision, Pires took the name of Solomon and showed up yet more terrible visions, owing presumably to his bodily weakness. Their input always had reference to the Moranos and their redemption by
checking system performance.
His own account of strange being magic, he needed him from heaven in a dream, charged him to leave Portugal and set out for Turkey. David Ruin then also had advised that he should leave Portugal with all speed, as the act of circumcision might involve also David in danger, and thus greatest schemes. Leaving Portugal cannot, then, have been difficult for Moranos. Now your competitors or Solomon will show reach Turkey, and hope for a messianic mission in the martyr's death. A great sensation was made there by this enthusiastic, handsome young catalyst, the new Jewish recruit. At first he gave himself out and bounded from David Ruin his good reception from the people in Portuguese was rumors recurrent even in the East, and had not failed to inflame people's imagination.
Okay.
In Salonica, Joseph T. Jesus' catalyst of took possession of him, and greedily listened to his dreams and visions. Had Adrian Noble though showed him great his catalyst of mind just Carl, who had left Spain when a boy, and had hitherto busied himself entirely with Talmudic learning. Enthusiasm is infectious. Carl fell into the same catalyst of enthusiasm as Molchow 497. He also had his dream fonder Nagid, who taught him elegant, mystical interpretations of scriptural passages, and revealed the future. He was so faithful and imitator that, like Molchow, he lived in the most certain expectation of being burnt at the stake as a burnt sacrifice of a sweet frog unto the Lord. Molchow inoculated his followers with the longing for martyrdom. His captivating person, pure enthusiasm, romantic disposition, past career, astonishing knowledge of the catalog of one a Christian, everything connected with him, raised up a host of adherents, who eagerly listened to his mystic utterances, and believingly accepted him. He often preached, and words flowed like a torch from his lips. Greatly connected with questions to the youth, seeking explanations of the scriptures of scripture.
I'm getting so much frame lag, I'm going to restart, so I'll just get back on later. I'm not really due on until 5:30, so this, just trying to get my schedule back. Like I sort of need to be getting up at 3:30 to get some stuff done, but I kind of shift there. 3:30 is like ideal. But, sorry if it's,
His fame and the of the Morales had yet more firmly to their visions of messianic redemption, and to David Ruin any, who, before we got 498 his consent, they took one foreigner of Messiah. Their fusion was so complete that they both inaugurated enterprises which could only end in death for themselves. Several Smash Marathas, Dentistry, have previously hung out at least a direction point for a cabin hangar, where they were suffered to remain unmolested. A company of young people from among them ventured to attack the Daijos, whence they fled, for the purpose of rescuing some Marauder women in addition to the Inquisition dungeons. Their corruption greatly alarmed the inhabitants, but they succeeded in rescuing the unfortunate victims. The incident made a great stir in both countries, and led to most prejudicial results for the pseudo-Christians. This occurrence, as well as the denunciation of several Marauders, were disrespect to an image of the Virgin Mary, and that induced the king to consider the scheme of establishing a holy Inquisition. David Bowie then gave her with a handful of rules of brief duration. He was at first received by Joe Dirt with extraordinary friendliness, and often admitted to audience when conversation was carried on our knees of the Arab and Portuguese interpreter, and received the distinct promise that each of 10,000 pylons should be placed at his disposal to enable his brother, the alleged king of Tyvar, to make war upon the Turks and Arabs, but the king gradually cooled down. Miguel de Silva, Portuguese ambassador at the papal court while David was at Rome, had called the alleged Jewish prince of Tyvar to be an adventurer. He was recalled to Portugal, and opposing the other counselors, who were deluded by David's daring character, made strenuous efforts to deprive him of the king's favor. Moreover, the homage so remarkably and openly offered to him by the Marauders had roused suspicion concerning him. Miguel de Silva, being trusted.
Major bug, right, really huge. Alright, my computer hasn't been restarted in days and it needs to be done. So I'm going to end this.